Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can create objects, tabs, and apps. So in this single video, I will be completing all these three parts. So I'm clicking on login with these credentials. Meanwhile, you can see how you can search me on YouTube. You can type my name, Sanjay Gupta. My channel will be available there. So here you can watch various programming related videos. So now we are logged in Salesforce. So first of all, let me tell you how you can create objects, then followed by tab and then app. So if you want to create object, so in setup, you need to type object. So here you can select the option create object. So here you can see in my previous video, I demonstrated you how we can create object. So that was individual video. But in this video, I am summing up all three parts like object, tab, and app. So I'm going to quickly create new object. So name of or label of object will be employee. Its plural label will be employees. Its unique name is employee. Then here you can write certain description like this object is related to employees in an organization, right? Then here we need to put a record name label. So here label is employee name. So previously I chose data type as text in previous video, but in this video I'm going to choose auto number so that you can get familiar with this also. So while choosing auto number, each record will be having a unique number. So we need to provide a format. So you can see the example for display format. So I'm choosing this display format. As our object is employee, so I choose E, then hyphen, then inside curly braces, 4 times zeros, and starting number will be this 0001. You can click on this, what is this? So here, brief description will be available. So you can click, so window will be open and you can read about this description, right? Then we have some optional features like if you want to allow reports, activities, you want to allow track field history, you want to allow this object in chatter groups. So if you want to allow this object for these things, then you can check these options, otherwise leave them as it is. Later on after creating this object, you can also modify these settings. Then object classification, I'm leaving them as it is. So I'm leaving rest of the things as it is and I'm clicking on save. So this way you will see our employee object is created. Its unique name, unique API name is employee underscore underscore C. So as you know, underscore underscore C represents that this is a custom object. If we are using any standard object, so we will not see this underscore underscore C. Then these are the things that we can create for this object like standard fields, custom fields. So standard fields are by default created. We can create new fields as custom fields and rest of the things. So these things you will learn in later videos, like how we can create lookup filters, validation rules, etc. So this way we created this object, but we cannot access this object without the help of tab. So to navigate on this object, we always require a tab. So now we are going to create tabs. So for student object, we have one tab, but for this employee object, we don't have any tab. So now I'm going to click on new. So here I'm selecting employee. So Salesforce automatically shows the objects for which you have not created tabs yet. Then you need to select a tab style. So if I click on this lookup, it will open a window. You can select any option for tab style, then clicking on next. Now here it is asking for the profile permissions. So in Salesforce, we have different profiles for different users. So you can provide tab settings for these users. So there are two options. You can apply one tab visibility for all profile, or you can apply different tab visibility for each profile. So if you select first option, so we have three options: default on, default off, and tab hidden. So if we choose default on, it means your tab will be available at the top, like this: home, chatter account, contacts. If you choose default off, then your tab will be created, but it will be available while you will be clicking on this plus sign, right? So it shows all the tabs. So here you can find your tab. And if you choose tab hidden, then this tab will not be available for you. So if we apply one tab visibility to all profile, then we choose default on or default off. We don't prefer tab hidden. If we want to apply tab visibility for a particular profile separately, then we can choose any of these three. Like if we don't want to show this tab for these analytics cloud integration users, so we can choose tab hidden. And for other, like, we can choose default on, default off, and so on. So this depends upon the requirement of the business. So right now I am choosing first option as default on. Then I'm clicking on next. Now here you can see it is showing names of applications that are already available in our org. So we need to place the tab on a particular application so that we can access it. So right now you can see all the checkboxes are checked. It means this tab will be available on each application. But in real-time scenario, we don't do this. We just select a particular application where we want to place this tab. So in this video, after this section, I will demonstrate you how we can create our own app. But meanwhile, I'm choosing this university app because this is also a custom app that I created in earlier video. So I'm going to place this tab right now on this application. But after this, we will learn how we can create new application as well. So I created the tab, and that tab will be available on university app. So if we want to check that, so we need to switch to that application. So you can see here it is university. So if we select this app, it will be open up. And here you can see this employee tab is available here. Right, so this way we can create tabs for particular objects so that we can do certain operations like creating records, deleting records, modifying records, and display the data which are available in the records. Right, so after this, now again moving to setup. Now the time is to create custom application. So for that, you can type apps, click on apps. So these are the apps which are already available. This one is the custom app that I created. Rest of the apps are provided by the Salesforce that we cannot delete. We can just edit them. Now we are going to create new app. So we need to select custom app, click on next. Now title, like I'm taking as hospital. So we have employees both in hospital and university. So that's why this object tab can be used in both the places. But in real time scenarios, we don't do this. We just create a particular object for a particular application because there can be scenarios like some of the fields or records are available or not available. So don't try to use same object for different applications. Try to create different objects. So it purely depends on the business requirement, whether you can use single object for multiple application or you need to create different objects for different applications. Now for this app, we can place the logo. So as you can see at top left corner, this Salesforce logo is available for this app. So by default, for each app, Salesforce provide their own logo. But if you want to place logo as per the business requirement, so you can read this description, like logo should be must be smaller than 20 KB. Its pixel size will be 300 × 55. So this way you can put a particular logo. So right now we are not placing any logo. We are using Salesforce default logo. Now this is the time where we can place the tabs that we want on this application. So I'm choosing accounts. I'm choosing contacts. So these are standard tabs. Now we created one more tab like employee. So I choose that also. Then it is showing option for default landing page. So as we open our application, which tab you want to open by default? So you can select a particular option. So I'm selecting home. Then next, again profile, for which profile you want to make this app visible. So right now I'm logged in with system admin user, like my profile is system admin. So I'm choosing that only. And if you want to choose any other profile as per the business requirement, that you can do also. Like if you want to make this app visible to other users also, so you can choose profiles accordingly. Now I'm clicking on save. So this app is created now. You can see it here. Here it is, hospital, right? Now we need to navigate to hospital app. So here in the list, you can see this app is available here. So click on this app. So now we are moving from university app to hospital. So here you can see home, accounts, contacts, and employees. Four tabs are available. So friends, this way, in this video, I together explained or demonstrated you how you can create custom objects, custom tab, and custom application. I hope you understood all the things. So if you want to watch more videos related to programming, you can watch my, you can search me on YouTube also. Thank you for watching this video.